Good start to another Twisted League video. Trying to get 75 thieving and I get a Xerix talisman that I can dismantle for 100 more teleports. Sweet. And another one. That was really, really quick. I feel pretty lucky. I saw some people go all the way to 80 thieving without getting one. And here we go. This is going to be 75 thieving for that gemstall thief, which is going to give me 250 league points. It's crazy. On the hunt for a rune scimitar right now, and I get a dragon stone. That's going to be a glory in the future, most likely. So I just got my rune scimitar after like a total of 350 fire giant kills, which is really, really sweet. But I just wanted to say, you might have noticed that I have a new profile picture on YouTube, and it's actually my girlfriend that made it to me. So if you want to go show some support to her, please do. By the way, I have linked her Instagram or whatever in the comments. So I had an elite clue score in my bank from woodcutting, I think, so I just thought I'd complete it, and let's see what it's going to give me. Probably the worst possible elite I could actually get. It's some fashionscape, but other than that, it's only the purple suites that I can use, but that is 50 points, and that's why I mainly did it. As I didn't ever do much barbarian fishing, I only did it to 60. I have not got 40 agility, so I thought that is some easy points, so that is exactly what I'm going to do now. Probably I'll get like 65 fishing or something from it as well, so some more total levels, I guess. And also, when I do get 40 agility, which is in 13 experience if I can just catch a fish, I will actually have base 40s, which is going to give me another 50 points, so when I get this right now, I am going to claim 100 league points from that, so let's do that real quick. Sweet, 690 left. Also for some free points, I completed an easy and a medium clue, so let's get these open, starting with the easy one. Extremely terrible, but at least the task is done. And a medium for Lovakenja Banner. Yeah, nothing great really, not Ranger Boots exactly, but let's complete the tasks and yeah, 20 points. Easiest points you could ever imagine incoming. I went from 60 to 65 cooking, made these pizzas, then I turned 20 of them in and you get 100 points. Traveled back to Tithe Farm to get 71 farming so I can boost for the last seed and get 250 points. All you have to do is plant them, let them die, and here we go, 250 points. That is actually just insane. I had not actually completed this, but the Depths of Despair completed for some nice points as well, 50 points. So I'm working on unlocking Broad Fletching now from Slayer Master so I can actually make a rune crossbow in the future. And I'm about to kill my last one, here we go, 258 points, so that is what, 42 more points, and I got 7 mediums on that task as well. Another task about to be completed, I already completed 1 medium, so here's 9 more for 10. And let's see if we can get some adamant items. Oh, adamant full helm, nice, that is one of the... Oh, adamant plate! Oh, and a samurai cloak! I didn't actually have a cloak at all, so that is a huge upgrade. I only need the adamant plate legs now. Oh, gnomish fire lighters. Very useless, but pretty cool, I guess. Adamant sword, that's not what I want. Let's bank and get the caskets out again. I want the adamant plate legs just for a clue step. That is going to happen in the future, probably. And that's a lot of adamant, but not the adamant plate legs. And another task completed as well. 10 medium clues. Time to unlock this. And yeah, I know that the broad bolts don't give that much experience when you fletch them, so you need to actually make the arrows, but I'm using an MSB now anyway, as you can see, 150 experience for that, and it is 750 if you make the arrows. So the arrows is how I'm going to actually get my experience to 69, but making broad bolts is really important as well for the future run crossbow. So I got 7.5k almost arrow shafts, and I'm going to have to feather them all, and it's, 750 experience per 15 you make. This is going to be very fast to 69 fletching. So there's two primary ways I might focus on getting the rune crossbow, either getting the rune limbs from steel dragons or iron dragons, or do master clues and kill the wizards for the drop. You still need the fletching level because the wizards drop the rune crossbow use, you still need to fletch it, but here's the first hard, I'm trying to get a master clue. Another hard, let's see if we can get a master. Nope. Third one, maybe a master in this one. That is so bad. Fourth one then, at least a lot of alchemists. That is almost even worse than the last one. Okay, got two more this time, let's see if we can get a master. Okay, first one is terrible. Second, oh, dude, that's ancient van braces. That is actually an upgrade, and also ancient again, so I have even more ancient items. I'm going to soon have full ancient. Thought I would do a medium as well, so we have a medium and two hards. Let's see what the medium is. Trimmed item. Some Lawrence. Lawrence is the best there. Oh, enchanted top. That is actually really, really good for magic. That's better than the Ceresian or whatever it's called. and a blessing, but no master clue, unfortunately. Just opened this while running and I got 2 Samurak items and a bunch of Alkeballs, so guess it's not too bad, but it's not a master which I need. Hey, we did it! That didn't take all too long, like 7 hard clues or something. So yeah, let's see if we can get a good wizard step now. So this kind of sucked. I got the wizard step twice, but both of the times they were down there and there's no way to un-aggro them. So I just had to kill them without actually farming them. So let's see what the master casket is going to give us anyways. Some herb lore supplies, but other than that, not too good. I'll probably just get the rune limbs from the iron dragons or shield dragons, but I'm going to finish the books here for 50 points and some experience lamp of like 50,000 experience. So I'm getting the last page for the book. I only need one more page to complete it, and I'm going to kill these temple spiders for that, so shouldn't be too long, and I only need 210 more points. Last page, which took me like 5 minutes maybe, so that was very easy. I also got a weapon poison P+, actually, so I can put that maybe on a weapon in the future if I get like the dragon host or something. In search of knowledge completed for 50 points, which I will claim in a bit, but the experience lamp I will definitely put on herb lore, so let's just do that real quick. Confirm, and 50,000, that is 52 herb lore, quite a lot of gains. And let's go in here and, oh, I have to walk a bit. Claim the task points, which should be 50. I was 1 total level of 1500, so I just did that real quick with some gems in crafting, and that is a bunch of points, 100. So I'm just grinding out 80 strength to unlock my last relic, which is going to be the time when I can actually play the game and have a bunch of fun. I mean, I have been playing the game a bunch and stuff like that, but, oh, scroll box, easy, sweet. But what I mean is I can just do whatever I want, and my goal is actually to just grind Slayer hard and get clue scrolls and do all that type of stuff, and primarily try to get to Abyssal Demons really, really fast and like Hydras and all that and get some really cool weapon unlocks. So that is going to be really fun. I thought actually making it to the last relic in my last video would be like a 1-day thing from 1000 points, but it took me 2 days. So it took a bit longer, and that's why this video is a bit delayed. I usually upload every 2 days, but now it's every 3 day on this one. Hopefully I can upload in 2 days time after this one is uploaded. But as I said earlier in the video, my channel art, the profile picture is made by my girlfriend, and she has an Instagram and she's really good at art. And if you guys want to go there and just like give a like to one of her pictures or something like that, that would be so appreciated. Like, it would mean so much. So it would be really cool if you guys would do that. She's also, as I said, I think I said at least, she's working on my banner, so my channel won't look like shit anymore, which is really, really nice. And if you, by the way, like my videos, please leave a like. But this is not the end of the video, so let's get that 80 strength. Finally, we will actually achieve the last relic after I actually hit one of these sand crabs. There we go, 80 strength achieved. Which also is very good for my future Abyssal Demon killing, which I will probably do with melee. There we go, and let's unlock the Xeric's Wisdom, which is by far the best one to grind out points, because double experience is just really overpowered in this mode, because it stacks with the other ones, so my melee will be times 20. Just finishing up a Steel Dragon task, and the experience is just insane. I get a Heart and Elite in the same drop, which is really good, because Elites can give Rune Crossbows. I'm not joking, in 8 Steel Dragon kills, I got 542,000 magic experience, and oh, 64 prayer as well, sweet. So I have 2 Elite caskets here. I'm really, really hoping for the Rune Crossbow. Let's see what the first one's going to be. No Rune Crossbow, but Mahogany Planks is really good for construction in the future, and oh, we got it, and 2 of them, okay, and so many planks as well, and a bucket of them. Looking like an absolute beast with my Rune Crossbow. Let's open these 5 Brimstone Keys that I had. First one, 35 diamonds, actually really good, 100 gold, 25 rubies, I really want gems, oh, even more gems. Dude, what? 3 uncut rubies in one, or 3 keys in a row, really good. So maybe I should explain why I was so excited about the gems. I mean, I'm going to do a bunch of Slayer and I'm going to get a lot of Brimstone Keys, and stacking up those gems is going to be pretty much free 99 crafting in the future. Crafting is quite annoying in the Twisted League, and it's going to be pretty easy, I think, and very doable with the gems that you get from Konar and from PVMing in general. Like, now I've got 2 as well and I always pick them up, and in the future I will just pretty much use all of them and get a shit ton of experience. But look at this, it's not 69 left because I did some on my phone, I think it's more like 30 left. And I put this counter up here when I started the Slayer assignment, and I was also, I think, 74 Slayer, no, sorry, I was not 74, I was 73 Slayer, and now I'm 74 and almost a whole level again in this task, and 1.5 almost million range experience. So I can finally progress my account, feels really good. Oh my god, look at this dude! Dragon Warhammer, 107 combat. That is the first Dragon Warhammer I've seen on the Twisted League. It's probably slightly better than maybe a Dragon Sword from the Worms. I'm not sure, but the spec is definitely really, really good anyways. I looked away from my screen for like 2 seconds. I look back, and all the jellies are just stacked in a row. What did I just come back to? Also got Mithril Boots, by the way, that is a clue step. I got 180 Blood Veld, so I have a lot of them to kill, but I just hit 1525 total, 97 range and 77 Slayer, so I'm really close to 99 ranged now. So on my future Slayer tasks, I will probably buy a bunch of Broad Bolts to make, and Feathers obviously, and I will just do this between the kills. Like you can see, I can fletch a bit, shoot, fletch a bit, and I misclicked, feels bad. But yeah, you can just do this because the rune crossbow is not that fast, so you can just click a few fletches and then click on the monster again and get free fletching experience along the way, which is probably going to be the way I get 99 fletching or with broad arrows. But yeah, I'm going to get a bunch of bolts this way, which will be very good for Slayer and PVMing in the future. So I don't have to pick up every single broad bolt that I use, which is really obnoxious because I don't have the accumulator. This just makes it way easier. About to get 98 ranged, and I get a bunch of ensouled heads from these as well, which are like 20,000 prayer experience each, so we'll get a lot of experience from those as well. Finished my task, and I now can unlock superiors with 150 points, and I am only 100k to 99 ranged. So I built the toolkit tier 4 for the ring mold, because I'm going to use my dragonstone that I got earlier for a ring of wealth, because I don't have a ring at all on this account, and I actually thought making a glory would be the best, but if you have a ring of wealth, you will get more rare drop table items, aka more dragonstones. So I thought it would just be the best thing as a snowball effect. So I cut some gems, got 55 crafting, and here we go, we have the dragonstone ring. Let's go into the magic book and enchant that. Now I have my first ring that I can use, the ring of wealth equipped. So now we will hopefully get a lot more rare drop table items. Had 5 brimstone keys from that, so let's first unlock the superiors. Let's go down here, and where's the superiors? There we go, confirm, that is now unlocked. And let's get these 5 brimstone chests open. First one, diamonds, perfect crafting experience, a lot of coins. Third one, uncut rubies, even more crafting experience. Redwood tree seed, don't really need that, already have one. And the last one is, what is that? Uncut rubies, even more crafting experience, perfect. So I'm actually going to end the video here, even though I'm so close to 99 ranged, because I want to get the video out today. It's been 3 days, usually I upload every 2 days, but I can't actually play more today, so that's why I'm ending it right here. So in the next one, I will definitely bang out 99 ranged and a bunch of other things, hopefully some clue scrolls as well and all that good stuff. And if you did like the video, please leave a like. It really means a lot to me to get a good like ratio on the video. It means you guys enjoy the videos, and they have been really good lately, so I'm really happy about that. And if you want to know when I post my future videos, then make sure to subscribe. Okay, have a good one, guys. Take care.